We'll start off with some breaking news. Congress MP Hanumanth Rao has hit out to the rapist interview, saying that they will take up the issue of the interview in the Rajya Sabha tomorrow. Also questioning the BBC, saying that it is a reputed organization. Why air views of a rapist?
You see that this type of person who has done this thing is a culprit, and the entire country was a Nirbhaya issue. Is everybody is feeling very bad, and the way of the rapist, the rape they have done. After that, that BBC is taking interview for this, means this is not correct, because BBC also can think about the sentiment of the people of this country, and especially women. Women, entire women, they are coming on the road, and your other side, your the how you has done, why you have done this type of interview. It is again you are giving some opportunity to this type of activities. People will do it, so we can stop this type of, even media also, even BBC or whatever is the BBC have got a good name, but this type of interviews they can take, so people will hurt. And especially I am hurt this type of this thing. Future it should not be taken. That is my point.
You think the Congress should plan to speak to Home Minister regarding this?
Yeah, definitely, because of how they can take, because tomorrow I can raise this issue. Tomorrow in the Parliament, definitely I will take this issue.
In Lok Sabha?
Okay. Yeah, Rajya Sabha. Thank you.
And it's a shocker from Nirbhaya's rapist. One of the main accused in the gang rape case, Mukesh Singh, has blamed the victim for the fatal sexual assault. In a shocking interview given to the BBC, Mukesh said that while being raped, Nirbhaya shouldn't have fought back. She should have just remained silent and allowed the rape to happen. One of the attackers that was found dead in jail in March of 2013. Another juvenile member of the gang was sentenced to 3 years in a reform home. But the four attackers, including Mukesh Singh, were convicted and sentenced to death last year. Mukesh Singh, who was 26 at the time of the attack, was driving the bus, whilst also claimed that his execution will make life more dangerous for future rape victims. In shocking remarks, he also suggested that the rape and beatings were to teach Nirbhaya and her friend a lesson that they should have not been out late at night. On 16 December 2012, the 23-year-old woman was brutally assaulted and tortured with an iron rod on the bus by six men, one of them a 17-year-old. She died 13 days later. And Kamaljeet Sandhu, our correspondent, now joining us live on the story. Kamal, we understand that besides her parents obviously reacting to this outrageous interview, the Indian government, specifically the MHA and sections of the Congress, have also taken offense. The fact that the BBC, which is a well-reputed news organization, actually played out the interview of this rapist.
The BBC interview with a rapist has obviously ruffled a few feathers, and that is why we see staunch reactions really coming in, whether it's from the Ministry of Home Affairs or whether it is from the parliamentarians. Clearly, Rajnath Singh even talking to the DG of Tihar Jail, asking for a report, and obviously they want to know whether all rules were adhered to before that kind of permission was given. Even though from our sources we have come to know it's not really peculiar that such kind of interviews have not taken place. There have been documentaries on Tihar Jail. There have been people who've been spoken to, but this is obviously seeing the sensitivity of the particular case. Remember, the case is still pending in the Supreme Court. There has been a lot of opinion, and we've seen a lot of people. And obviously, we spoke to Hanumanth Rao, and he did tell us about how he plans to raise this particular issue on the Zero Hour. And we also spoke to Nirbhaya's parents.